In the last session, we were discussing this chapter, concept of revenue. And until now, we have discussed these topics. First of all, in this chapter, we have understood the meaning of revenue, wherein I have explained that revenue is the total amount. Revenue is the amount received by a firm after sale of quantity of a commodity in the market. And concept of revenue can be further divided into three categories, that is total revenue, marginal revenue, and the average revenue. We have also understood the meaning of total, marginal, and average revenue. In total revenue, I've told you that total monetary receipt from the sale of a given quantity of a commodity is called total revenue. Then average revenue is the revenue generated per unit of output, and average revenue is always equal to the price of the commodity. That is what I have already explained. Average revenue and price of the commodity is one and the same. And I think we have proved this as well. And after this, marginal revenue is also covered. Marginal revenue is the revenue generated by selling an additional unit of the commodity. Then we have done few questions based on the total revenue, marginal revenue, and the average revenue. And in the last class, we have started this relationship between different type of revenues. So first of all, in order to create relationships, we actually have to cover two relationships in the chapter. We have to establish relationship between the total revenue and marginal revenue. And then we are also required to establish relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. So in this chapter, we have to create relationship between two different types of revenue, TR and MR, and then AR and MR. But in order to establish relationship between different type of revenues, we have to understand the different type of market first. So because depending upon the market situation, the relationship between the total and marginal varies, and similarly average revenue and marginal revenue, the relationship between AR and MR also varies depending upon the market situation. So as I told you in the last class, that we have two types of market. One is called the perfect competition, and the other is called imperfect competition market. One of the characteristics of the perfect competition is that in perfect competition market, the price of the commodity remains constant. Seller can sell any number of units at the same price. He is not required to reduce price of the commodity in order to sell more units of the commodity. But on the other hand, in case of imperfect competition, if seller is willing to sell more quantity to the customers, then in that case, he will be required to reduce price with every extra unit that he wants to sell. So one of the characteristics of the imperfect competition is that price in the imperfect competition goes on declining. But in case of perfect competition, price will always remain constant. All right. So we have first created relationship between the TR and MR in case of imperfect competition. Imperfect competition basically means the market wherein the prices are declining. So I have explained this table in the last class, and I think we have also understood the diagrammatic representation of the total revenue and the marginal revenue in case of imperfect competition. This is how the diagrammatic representation of TR and MR will be done. And based on the diagrammatic representation, we can establish relationship. These are the relationship that we have covered in the last class. One of the relationship was that marginal revenue decreases as the total revenue. When marginal revenue decreases, total revenue increases, but at a decreasing rate. Then when marginal revenue becomes zero, total revenue reaches its maximum point and it becomes constant. And after that, I have told you that marginal revenue is negative. When marginal revenue is negative, then total revenue starts to decline. So these are the different types, different relationship between the TR and MR. Okay. So I think we did only one relationship, no? Samiksha? How many relationships we have done in the last class? We have done only one, TR and MR, or anything else other than this?
Sir, we did this.
We did only TR and MR, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's now discuss the relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. And let me explain you the relationship on a separate note. Just a minute. Yes. So First of all, in order to create the relationship between the total and the average revenue, sorry, marginal and the average revenue, in case of imperfect competition, we will be required to create the table. So let's create table first of all. Let's suppose this is output. This is the various quantity that a firm is selling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And let's also suppose that these are the prices of the commodity. And because we are talking about which kind of market, we are talking about imperfect competition. So right now we are discussing imperfect competition market. So as you know, in case of imperfect competition market, what happens? The price of the commodity goes on declining. So output, as output increases, price of the commodity will decrease. So let's start, the initial price was 10. So it goes down to 9, 8, 7, then 6 and 5. And finally, for the 7th unit, it is 4. Okay, now let's calculate, because we need to establish relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. So we will have to find out the average and marginal. But in order to do that, we will have to first find out the total revenue. So total revenue for the first unit will be 10. For the second unit, it will be 18. For the third unit, it will be 24. For the fourth unit, it will be 28. Then 30. Again, 30 for the sixth unit. And for the seventh unit, it will be 28. Okay. Now, find out the marginal revenue, first of all. So marginal revenue will be, because as I told you that at the first unit, marginal revenue, total revenue always remains constant. So 10 at the first unit, then 8, then 6, then 4, then 2, then finally 0, and then negative. This is the marginal revenue. And now we will calculate the average revenue. So this is the average revenue. And as we have already learned in the last class, that average revenue is always equal to the price of the commodity. So we are not required to calculate the average revenue separately. We can just copy paste the value of the prices. So the prices are 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 4, 8, 7, just a minute. I think I've done some mistake. 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4. This is the average revenue. Is this clear to everyone? Everyone knows the concept between the average revenue and price.
Yes.
That average revenue is always equal to the price of the commodity. Junaid and everyone else.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will establish relationship. Now see what is happening. First of all, average revenue and marginal revenue is starting from the same point, correct? Both marginal revenue and average revenue is starting from the same point. At first unit, value of the marginal revenue is also 10 and average revenue is also 10. So both are starting from the same point, number one. Next, as the output increases, as the seller sells more unit of the commodity, you can see, as seller is selling more units of the commodity, the both average revenue and marginal revenue is declining. See, average revenue is also declining. Average revenue is going down. Marginal revenue is also going downwards. All right. But one thing that you will notice here is that even though both are decreasing, let me just first erase this. Okay. So even though both are decreasing, you will notice that marginal revenue is decreasing at a greater pace. Marginal revenue is decreasing at a greater pace. Let's see. Let's talk about average revenue. Average revenue decreases from 10 to 9. It decreases by how many units? It decreases by 1 unit only. But let's focus on the marginal revenue. Value of the marginal revenue decreases from 10 to 8. Tell me how much is the change in the marginal revenue? 2 unit. Next time, for the third unit, average revenue is again goes down from 9 to 8. One rupee change in the average revenue. But marginal revenue is changing by how much? 2 rupees. Got it? So whatever the change in the average revenue is taking place, average revenue changing twice as compared to the average revenue. So that means as output increases, average revenue decreases and both marginal revenue also decreases. Average revenue, marginal revenue both decreases as output increases. Got it, everyone? But the rate of decrease in average revenue, but the rate of decrease in marginal revenue is always greater than the decrease in the average revenue. Whatever the decrease in the average revenue, the decrease in the marginal revenue is always greater as compared to the decrease in the average revenue. Tell me, is this clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to see this on the table? Is this visible? Is this relationship is visible to you on the table? That first of all, both are starting from the same point. This is one of the relationship. Then both are decreasing. This is the relationship. But MR is decreasing at a greater pace. In fact, there is a difference of 2 times between the average revenue and marginal revenue. Marginal revenue is declining twice as compared to the average revenue. Okay. Now, second relationship, you can write it as marginal, you can see marginal revenue is getting zero, right? Marginal revenue is becoming zero. And it also, after some point, it can get negative as well. So this proves that marginal revenue can be zero, first of all. Then marginal revenue can also be negative. Correct, everyone? But you can see average revenue is not getting zero. Average revenue can never be zero. This is one of the characteristics of the average revenue. And as it can never be zero, therefore, it can never be negative as well. That means this is the second relationship between the average and the marginal, that marginal revenue can be zero, marginal revenue can be negative, but average revenue cannot be zero, can never be negative. This is the second relationship. Third relationship, we can write it as that both start from the same point, but MR both declines as output increases. That this means the when you will draw the diagram of the average revenue and marginal revenue, you will notice that the diagrammatic in the diagrammatic representation, both AR and MR curves, MR and AR curve fall downward. This is the third relationship. Falls downward. This is the third relationship. I'll be drawing the diagram. I'll be showing you this relationship. But for now, just tell me, is both the above relationships is clear to both of you, all of you? Average revenue is declining, marginal revenue also declining, but the rate of decrease in the MR is greater than the rate of decrease in the AR. Is it clear? The first relationship?
Yes.
Then the second relationship is also clear, that marginal revenue can be zero, can be negative, but average revenue cannot be negative, can yes, never sir. Be zero.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let's make the diagrammatic representation of both the types of revenue. So in order to make the diagram, we will be taking two axes. This is y-axis, this is x-axis. So on the y-axis, we will be taking the value of the, first of all, the value of the average revenue. Average revenue. And also we will be showing the value of the we are creating relationship between the marginal. Okay. So the marginal revenue. Marginal revenue. And on the x-axis, we will be showing the quantity of commodity. Okay. Now you will notice that both the curves start from the same point, but let's first make the diagram for the marginal revenue. You will notice that if marginal revenue is starting from this point, let's say it is starting from this point, but as we already know that marginal revenue always goes on declining, right? Marginal revenue always declines with the increase in output. So marginal revenue will go on declining. It will reach zero and it will eventually becomes negative as well. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the marginal revenue curve. Similarly, average revenue, when you will draw the diagram for the average revenue, you will notice that average revenue falls as the output increases. Average revenue goes on declining, but the diagram, but the curve of the average revenue always remains above the marginal revenue, and it never goes to zero, neither it becomes negative. So this will be the diagram for the average revenue. Tell me everyone, is this clear that both the curves will start from the same point? Is this clear, all of you?
Yes.
Second thing, that marginal revenue can be zero. It can be negative as well. But average revenue cannot be zero, can never be negative. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
And second thing is that the average revenue curve will always lie above. It will always lie above the marginal revenue. Is this clear as well? Why it will always lie above the marginal revenue? Because the value of average revenue decreases, but it always remains greater than the marginal revenue. Even though average revenue is declining, but the value of average revenue always remains greater than the marginal revenue. See, after the starting point, see, marginal revenue is 8, average revenue is 9. That means average revenue is greater than marginal. Again, at this point, 8, 6, 8 is greater. 4 and 7, 7 is greater. 2 and 6, 6 is greater. 0 and 5, 5 is greater. Minus 2 and 4, 4 is greater. So at all the units of output, average revenue always remains greater than the marginal revenue. Therefore, when we present both the revenues on the diagram, you will notice that on the diagram, average revenue curve always falls above the marginal revenue curve. Tell me, is this clear, all of you? Junaid?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me show you this on the PowerPoint. So this is the tabular representation of the average revenue and the marginal revenue. So I have taken the quantity of the commodity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and these are the prices as usual, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, and this is total revenue. And on the basis of total revenue, I have calculated marginal, and then I have calculated the average revenue. Okay. Now see, this is how the diagrammatic representation of the marginal revenue will be done. And this will be the diagram for the average revenue. Okay. Now we will establish relationship. So with every additional unit sold, average revenue and marginal revenue both decreases. This is one of the relationship. Second thing is that rate of decrease in the marginal revenue is always twice of decrease in the average revenue. That is, the marginal revenue always decreases at a greater pace as compared to the average revenue. And finally, marginal revenue can be zero. I don't know what spelling I have written for zero. So this is zero actually, but there is a mistake in the spelling. So marginal revenue can be zero or negative, but average revenue can never be zero, nor it can be negative. All right, everyone. So these are the three relationship. You can also write one of the relationship, like both average revenue, marginal revenue start from the same point. This could be one of the relationship. And we can also write one more relationship, that the diagrammatic or the average revenue and marginal revenue curve both falls downward. Both are downward sloping curves. This can also be one of the relationship. So tell me, everything is clear on this slide? Any doubt, anyone? Arisha, Junaid?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So we have basically completed the relationship between total revenue and average revenue in case of imperfect competition. Just a minute. Yeah. So as I told you in the beginning of this chapter, that we have to cover relationship between, first of all, we need to cover the relationship between the total revenue and marginal revenue. And then we need to cover the relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. And these relationship have to be understood first of all in case of perfect competition. So we have, sorry, first of all, in case of imperfect competition, what is the relationship between the total and the marginal and average and marginal, but in case of imperfect competition market, wherein the prices are continuously declining. Now, again, we are also required to understand the relationship between the TR and MR. And again, AR and MR in case of perfect competition. So we have covered one part of this, of the relationship between TR and MR and AR and MR in case of imperfect competition. Now we will discuss the relationship between both these concepts in case of perfect competition. But always remember that in your examination, the question will be based on the imperfect competition. Most of the time, question is asked based on the imperfect competition only. Imperfect competition is not very important from examination point of view, but because it is in a syllabus, so I'll be discussing this. But make sure that you at least prepare this part, because this is going to be very important from examination point of view. This is not as important as compared to this. Okay, so now let's first understand the relationship between the total revenue and marginal revenue, that too in case of perfect competition. Okay, all right, so this is the tabular representation of the perfect competition. So these are the units of the commodity 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in case of perfect competition, as we know that price do not change, price remains constant for every additional unit of output sold. So 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, the price is constant at all the unit of output. And as we also know that price and average revenue is always same. Either you talk about the perfect competition or imperfect competition, average revenue is always equals to the price of the commodity. Therefore, here I have written price and average revenue. So both are same. Now, we will be calculating the total revenue. So total revenue will be at zero unit. Total revenue will be zero. For the first unit, we will sell 1 unit at ₹5, we will get ₹5 as a total revenue. So mechanism is same mechanics I'm using, price into quantity to calculate the total revenue. All right. Again, 2 into 5, we will get 10. Then 3 into 5, we'll get 15. 4 into 5, we will get 20. 5 into 5, we will get 25. So this is the total revenue. Now, because we need to establish relationship between the total and the marginal, therefore I'll have to calculate the value of the marginal revenue as well. So marginal revenue in this case will be same. It will remain constant. See, it is because the total revenue is increasing at a constant rate. No, from 0 to 5, it increases by ₹5. So marginal revenue is 5. Then again, from 5 to 10, it increases by ₹5. So marginal revenue is again 5. 10 to 15, the ₹5 increase in the total revenue, so marginal revenue will be 5. So you will notice that in case of perfect competition, total revenue goes on increasing at a constant rate. Total revenue increases at a constant rate. From 0, it goes to 5, then 10, then 15, then 20, then 25. And if we further sell more quantity, if more quantity is sold by the seller, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, you will notice that total revenue goes on increasing like this only. It will increase like 20 to 25, then 25 to 30, 30, 35, then 35 to 40, 40 to 45, and so on. Right? So this means that in case of perfect competition, total revenue always increases at a constant rate. On the other hand, marginal revenue always remains constant, because total revenue is increasing at a constant rate. That means marginal revenue will always be constant. If total revenue is increasing by ₹5, then marginal revenue will be 5 at all the units of output. Getting my point? That in case of perfect competition, marginal revenue remains constant, total revenue increases. It goes on increasing at a constant pace. It goes on increasing at a constant rate. Tell me, is this table clear to all of you? Junaid, Arisha, Samiksha?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, we are required to establish relationship between the TR and MR. So, this is how the relationship will be established. Let me just explain this on the note as well. Just a minute. See. So, we are talking about the perfect competition. Perfect perfect competition. Okay, so for the perfect competition, as I told you, output increases, price will remain same. Output from, let's say we are starting it from zero, so it goes to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. And price, let's say if I'm charging 10 rupees, so 10, price will always remains constant, 10, 10, 10, 10, and 10. And total revenue will be how much? Total revenue will be price into quantity, right? So it will be 0, then 10, then 20, then 30, then 40, 50, and 60. You can see that total revenue is increasing at a constant rate. Now we need to find out the value of the average revenue. So let's calculate, not average revenue, in fact, the marginal revenue, because we need to establish relationship between the total and the marginal only. So therefore, marginal is important, not average. So marginal for the first unit, zero unit will be zero. For the next unit, it will be 10. Then again, there is a increase into total revenue by 10. So marginal will remain constant at all the unit of output, 10, 10, and 10. All right. Now, if you draw the diagram for such a situation, you will notice that, let me just first prepare the diagram. So this is the y-axis, x-axis. Okay, and on y-axis, we will be showing the price of the commodity. Price of commodity. And on the x-axis, we will be indicating the, not price of the commodity, I'm sorry. On the y-axis, we will be indicating the value of, first of all, total revenue. All right, total revenue. And we will also indicate value of the marginal revenue on the y-axis. Okay. And on x-axis, we will indicate the value of the quantity of the output. Okay. So when you will draw the diagram for the average total revenue, you will notice that total revenue goes on increasing. It goes on increasing like this. It let's say if it is starting from this point, it will goes on increasing like this. It always remains constant. It goes on increasing like this. This will be the total revenue curve. This will be total revenue curve. On the other hand, marginal revenue, what will happen to the marginal revenue? It will goes on declining only. So not declining, sorry, because it is a perfect competition. So marginal revenue will be constant. So it will be something like this. This will be the marginal revenue. Tell me, is this clear, all of you?
Yes.
Total revenue curve will be upward sloping curve because total revenue is constantly increasing. And because it is increasing at a constant rate, therefore, it will be a straight line linear curve. It will be a linear curve. The total revenue curve will be a linear curve. And because marginal revenue is constant, it is increasing at constant rate, right? Increasing at constant rate. Therefore, it is linear curve, upward sloping. Linear curve, upward sloping. But if you talk about the marginal revenue, you will notice that marginal revenue is a straight line parallel to x-axis curve. It is parallel to x-axis. Why it is parallel to x-axis throughout the different unit of output? Because marginal revenue is throughout constant. And why marginal revenue is constant? Because price is constant. Therefore, marginal revenue is also constant. So let's now understand this on the PowerPoint. See, this is how the diagrammatic representation of the total and the marginal revenue will be shown. One curve will be the upward sloping, linear, basically it will start from the origin. It may start from the origin if you are willing to indicate the value of the total revenue at zero unit of output. So at zero unit of output, it will start from the origin. Now let's study the relationship between the TR and MR in case of perfect competition. This will be something like this. When price remain constant, firm can sell any quantity of output at price fixed by the market. That is, as a result, marginal revenue curve is a horizontal straight line parallel to x-axis. That is what I have told you, that marginal curve in such a situation will be straight line parallel to x-axis. Since marginal revenue remains constant, because marginal revenue is constant, therefore total revenue also increases at a constant rate. And due to this reason, total revenue curve is a positively sloped straight line. This is it. This is what the relationship between the total and the marginal revenue is in case of perfect competition. You need to explain this only. Tell me, everyone, is this clear? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now there is one more relationship. And can anyone guess what will be the next relationship? We are yet to cover one relationship, no? Average revenue and the marginal revenue. Yes?
Yes,
and that in that too in case of imperfect in case of perfect competition.
Okay, sir.
So in case of perfect competition, we will have to just a minute. So let me explain this first of all. Okay, so next is again relationship, this time between between the average revenue, right? Average revenue and relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. And we will be creating this relationship in case of perfect competition. Okay. And as I told you earlier, that relationship between AR and MR and TR and MR is not as important in case of perfect competition as compared to the imperfect competition. Imperfect competition is more important from examination point of view. Mostly imperfect competition is asked in exam. Okay, now when we create relationship between the average and marginal in case of perfect competition, you will be drawing the table something like this. Output 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's say these are the prices of the commodity. So prices are, let's say it is 20, 20, 20, 20. Because we are talking about the perfect competition, so price will remain constant. Now you will be required to calculate the value of total revenue. So total revenue will be 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, and finally 120. Now, because we need to calculate the relationship between the average and marginal, so we will have to find out the value of the average revenue and the marginal revenue as well. So calculation of average revenue is very simple. As I told you, average revenue always remains equal to the price of the commodity. So average revenue will be 20 only. 20, 20, 20, 20, and 20. On the other hand, marginal revenue is calculated as a difference of total revenue, different changes arising in the total revenue. So you will notice that there is an equal change in total revenue every time. At first unit, marginal revenue will be exactly equal to the total revenue, right? So 20 is the total revenue, so marginal revenue will also be 20. Now tell me, how much is the change in the total revenue for the second unit? How much is the change in the total revenue for the second unit?
20.
And for the third unit, it is again
20.
That means total revenue is going to remain constant as well in case of the perfect competition. So this means that at all the units, value of the average revenue and marginal revenue always remains constant, always remains same. Getting my point? In case of perfect competition, average revenue, marginal revenue, and price. In fact, price is the same thing. Price, average revenue, and marginal revenue. These are all same. Price is 20, AR is 20, marginal revenue is 20 at all the unit of output. Is this clear, everyone? That means average revenue and marginal revenue remains constant at all the units of output. Let's draw the diagram. There is an interesting diagram for this kind of situation. So first of all, let's make the axis, y-axis, x-axis. And because we need to create the relationship between the average and marginal, so on the y-axis, we will be showing the value of the average revenue and the marginal revenue. Marginal revenue. Okay. And on the x-axis, output or quantity will be indicated. All right. Now see, first of all, we will make the diagram for the, let's make the diagram for the average revenue. And we can see on the table that the value of the average revenue is throughout constant. So when you will draw the diagram, you will be drawing the diagram for the average revenue like this. It will be a straight line parallel to x-axis curve. This is the average revenue. Now we have to draw the diagram for the marginal revenue. And interestingly, average revenue, marginal revenue, both start from the same point. Number one, in case of perfect competition, I'm talking about. Number one, it starts from the same point from where the average revenue start. Secondly, it is exactly equal to the value of the average revenue. Therefore, when you will draw the diagram for the average revenue, it will exactly fall on the same line. The average revenue and marginal revenue will be same thing. This is how the marginal revenue will be presented. So average revenue and marginal revenue both falls in the same line. Both are exactly same. And it is also equals to the price of the commodity. So price line, average line, or marginal line is all same in case of perfect competition. Tell me, everyone, is this clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, it is also said that line, the area below the marginal revenue curve, so the entire area below the marginal revenue curve, indicate the value of the total revenue. So let's say this is the average revenue at all the unit is how much? It is 20, right? 20. Let's give the value 20. And let's say the average revenue at the fifth unit is also, it will also be how much? It will also be 20 only. Now I want to, let's give it the points. Let's say this is O point and this is Q point and this is A point and this is P point. All of these I have given them the points. I've named these points A, O, Q and P. So it is said that the area below the marginal revenue line or MR curve indicate the total revenue. So the entire area below the average revenue. So this is the average revenue, no? Or the marginal revenue. So the entire area below the marginal revenue line indicate the value of the total revenue. All right. So let's just calculate the value of the total revenue. So first of all, tell me what kind of figure it is making here. So this is a rectangle. Just a minute. So at this point, A, O, P and Q, I need to calculate area of this particular figure. So this is basically a rectangular figure, right? Rectangular figure it is. Yes or no? It is a rectangular figure. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now anyone can anyone is able to recall the formula for the area of the rectangle? It's L into B, I guess. Area of the rectangle is L into B, length into breadth. So length of this particular area, let's say this is the length. So length is 0 to 5. This is the 5. No, this is the quantity. So length we will take 5, and breadth is how much? Breadth is, this is the breadth, 20, 0 to 20. That means breadth is 20. So when you will multiply L into B, you will get how much? It will be 5 into 20. It will be how much? It will be 100. So at fifth unit, total revenue will be 100. So let's check it. Now let's look at the table. In the table, you will find that at the fifth unit, total revenue is how much? It is 100 only. Getting my point? This is why it is called area below the marginal revenue curve always indicate the value of the total revenue. Let me write this to make it more understandable. It is generally said that area under the marginal revenue curve, always indicate total revenue, and this is applicable to perfect competition market only. Not necessarily it will apply to the imperfect competition. Tell me everyone, is this clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Samiksha, is this clear for you as well? Samiksha is not here. Okay, only Steve and Junaid is written in the class. Okay, Arisha is also here. So Arisha, is this clear to you as well?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see, this is how the diagrammatic representation of the AR and MR will be done. And now you can read this. When price remains constant at all the level of output, then price equals to average revenue, and average revenue equals marginal revenue. Therefore, price line is the same as the marginal revenue curve, and also total revenue equals to IMR. So the area, okay. Let's just, for the time being, just skip this particular point. Just a minute. So just let's skip this point. Just only read this, that also the area under the marginal revenue curve or price line will be equal to the total revenue. That is what I have shown just now by calculating it. So in figure, total revenue and marginal revenue, total revenue at MR level. So this is the MR level. So this is the point R is indicated as the MR level in the question, in the figure. So when you will calculate total revenue at R point, you will find that the total revenue is equal to the, marginal revenue is equal to the total revenue. The area below the marginal revenue curve is equal to the total revenue. All right, I guess all of you must have understood this. So this is it. In this chapter, we have to study these relationship only. So if in examination, examiner will be asking relationship, they will specify some kind of relation, some kind of situation. They will, let's say they are asking for the relationship between the total revenue and the marginal revenue. If they ask for the relationship between the total revenue and the marginal revenue, then they will specify the situation, that whether they require the relationship to be established between the total and the marginal in case of perfect competition or in case of imperfect competition. So situation will be mentioned in the question in examination. All right, everyone. So there, just keep this in mind that relationship differs depending upon the market situation. If question will ask you relationship between the total and the marginal revenue, they will give you the market situation, whether the examiner is asking from the viewpoint of the perfect competition or the imperfect competition, that situation will be mentioned in the question. All right. But sir, what if question does not specify? What if question does not specify that in which kind of market the relationship is to be established? Let's say if question only says that establish the relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue, It says relationship between the average revenue and marginal established relationship between the or state relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. Market situation is not given. So listen to me very carefully. If market situation is not given, in that case, you will be writing the relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue. And that will be called general relationship. That will be called general relationship. So general relationship will be written if market situation is not given in the question. First of all, listen to me very carefully. If market situation is mentioned in the question, then you will have to establish relationship between the AR and MR according to the market type. If you have been asked to answer the relationship between the AR and MR in case of perfect competition, you will have to answer according to the perfect competition only. If question is specifying that they need the relationship between the average and marginal in case of imperfect competition, then you will have to answer in context of imperfect competition only. But what if question does not specify? In that situation, you will be writing the relationship between the AR and MR general relationship. In that case, general relationship will be written. So what is the general relationship in case of AR and MR? What is the general relationship between the AR and MR? So in order to understand, we will first of all just read this. The relationship between AR and MR depends on whether the price remains same or falls with the rise in output. On this basis, relationship between the AR and MR varies. But if nothing is mentioned about the nature of price with the rise in output, then the following general relationship exists between the AR and MR. So this relationship exists generally. This is the general. If nothing is mentioned, we will be answering according to the general relationship. And in case of general relationship, this is how the diagram for the average revenue and marginal revenue will be formed. Let me explain this on the note. Just a minute. Let me show you how the curves are formed. Most probably, this will not be asked in the examination. But still, for a safer side, I'm explaining this. So first of all, as usual, we will be drawing the curve. Just a bit. Okay. So average revenue curve and marginal revenue curve will be drawn. And on this axis, we will be showing the value of the quantity of the output. Okay. Now, see, in case of imperfect competition, first of all, marginal revenue curve will be formed. First of all, marginal revenue curve. Just a minute. Okay. So marginal revenue curve will be formed, and it will be formed like this. See, so it will be formed like this. First it will go upward, then it will reaches a maximum point, and then it goes on declining. And it may also go negative. So this is the marginal revenue curve. On the other hand, when you will have to draw the diagram for the average revenue as well. So average revenue, marginal revenue, both will start from the same point. Okay. And but the important thing is that average revenue always lie below the marginal revenue in case of general relationship. So it initially goes increase like this. It reaches a point of constant maximum, then it finally goes on declining. This is how it will be formed, average revenue, but it will not be zero, neither it will become negative. This is how the diagram for the average revenue, marginal revenue is formed. Let me explain this one more time. Let me again draw the diagram. So this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis. For average marginal revenue, we will first draw the marginal revenue curve. It will initially increase. It will go, it reaches maximum point, then it starts decreasing. It goes to zero and negative. Now, average revenue will initially increase as well. It increases, it reaches its maximum point, then it goes on declining. Again, this is marginal revenue, this is average revenue. Is this clear, all of you? The diagram is clear how it will be formed. you will have to remember this. There is, I'm not going to explain what is the mechanism, how it is actually formed. So you just have to keep this in mind. This is not very important from examination point of view, but because it is in syllabus, I'm explaining this. So how we will be creating the relationship, the first relationship between the average revenue and marginal revenue will be, see, we will be writing it as when, until when marginal revenue remains greater than the average revenue, until the point, until this point, see, before the point of intersection, let's give the intersection point a name. Let's give it point E. Name of the intersection point is point E. So before point E, you will notice that in this entire area, average revenue is less and marginal revenue is more. And you will also notice that when marginal revenue is greater than the average revenue, you will notice that average revenue is continuously increasing. It is going upward, right? So we can write it as when marginal revenue is greater than average revenue goes on increasing. This is the first relationship. Average revenue goes on increasing. Tell me, guys, is this clear? Until the point E or before point E, you will notice that marginal revenue is greater as compared to average revenue. How we can say that, sir? See, marginal revenue curve is greater than the average revenue curve. No, this proves that marginal revenue is more than the average revenue. And until marginal revenue is more than the average revenue goes on increasing. It continuously increases. But after the intersection point, after the point of intersection, you will notice that marginal revenue is less than the average revenue, as the average revenue curve is now upward as compared to the marginal revenue curve. So this proves that after the point of intersection, you will notice that marginal revenue is less than the average revenue, right? And when marginal revenue is less than average revenue, you will notice one thing, that average revenue is also, what is happening to average revenue? It is also declining. Average revenue is declining. Average revenue is decreasing. Everyone is able to see this?
Everyone? Yes,
sir. Yes. So these two are the relationship between the average and the marginal revenue. These are the general relationship. We can establish one more relationship, that when marginal revenue and average revenue are exactly equal. So at this point, at the point of intersection, you can notice that average revenue, marginal revenue, both are equal. So when marginal revenue, average revenue, both becomes equal, at that point, average revenue reaches its maximum point. Even average revenue become constant sometime. It becomes constant and it reaches its maximum point as well. It reaches its maximum. So these are the three general relationship between the marginal revenue and average revenue. This is it. This is the last topic of the chapter. So just keep this in mind. This is not very important, but still we need to cover this because this is part of syllabus. Obviously, this may be asked in the question. This may be asked in the examination. But most of the time, the relationship between the different type of cost is asked with respect to the imperfect competition only. So therefore, according to me, it is not as important as compared to the other topics. But still, because it is in syllabus, you will have to cover this as well. So general relationship will be, first will be average revenue, as average revenue increases as long as marginal revenue is higher than the average revenue. Then average revenue is maximum and constant when marginal revenue is exactly equal to the average revenue. And finally, when marginal revenue is less than the average revenue starts to fall. These are the three general relationship between the AR and MR. Tell me, everyone, is this clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? Arisha, any doubt? Anything you want to ask? Okay. So, guys, this is it. This is it for this particular chapter. We have finished this chapter and probably we will be starting a new chapter tomorrow. And that will be market structure, most probably, or else we will start one of the chapter from the statistics. So I'll decide that. Don't worry about that. Either we will start the forms of market, or we will start measures of dispersion from the statistics. Okay, so for the time being, we will take a break of 5 minutes, then we will continue with our accounts funds. Okay, so all of you stay connected. I'm taking a break of 5 minutes, then we will continue.